In this video, we are going to write a simple tool in Python to assist us coming up with an exploit strategy for the sudo heap corruption. Our problem is that we have a simple overflow into other data of the heap, and we need to figure out if there's any interesting data that we can overwrite. And very useful and powerful would be a function pointer. A function pointer is just an address that some other code uses for a function call. So if we overwrite that, we would be able to redirect code execution. So how can we figure out if that is the case for sudo? And would it be a feasible exploit strategy too? Let's find out. So my idea how to do that is very basic. It's actually not perfect, it has major weaknesses, but more on that later. For now, here's the rough plan. From the virtual memory map, we know what area contains code, all the areas that have the executable flag set. So we can search the heap for addresses in that range. If we find such an address, it could be a function pointer. Once we identified such a case, we could check if this address comes after the buffer we can overflow, so we can overflow this address. And we can combine this with the first idea from last video. We could write a tool that brute forces different heap layouts, hoping that the function pointers end up after our buffer. Here I'm back in GDB with the jeff.gdb extension. First I go where the overflow happens and I execute a few loop rounds. Now we have written some data into our buffer. Looking at the virtual memory map with VM map, we can see where the heap is. And then we can create a binary data dump from the start to the end of the heap. I write this dump into this heap file so we can write some code to find the function pointers in it. But to find possible function pointers, first we need to know all the address ranges with executable code. So I also copy the complete virtual memory map, put it into a new Python script, and I write a first loop going over each line. If we have readable and executable memory, this memory area probably is code. So we split this line into the individual parts and we get the start, end, size, and other stuff we don't really care. These values are in hex, so I convert them to an integer and add them to the memory map list. Next, we can open the binary heap dump and read it all into the heap variable. Next, we can create a loop that goes over the data by using a counter variable that starts at 0 up to the length of the whole data and counts up in bytes of 8. The file obviously starts at offset 0, but the real heap address starts at 5555F000. So we can also calculate here the current real heap address by adding the start address offset. And then for each offset, we are extracting a range of 8 bytes. Why counting in 8 bytes and extracting 8 bytes? Well, we have here a 64-bit binary and system, so addresses would be 8 bytes, and they should be 8-byte aligned. We then convert these 8 bytes to an integer, and then for each integer we extracted from the memory, we can loop over the memory list of executable memory, and we can check if that integer is in the range of this particular memory range. If that is the case, this address points into executable memory, and we can print it. This is likely a function pointer. Also, we know where our buffer that we overflow starts. It was at 6131E0. So if we reach that heap address, we also print that information. Now we can run our script and look at that. We get a collection of addresses that point into executable memory and also where our buffer we can overflow is. Unfortunately, it is at the end, so right now we couldn't overflow data into any of these addresses. But maybe by playing with the argument lens and other data that can influence the heap, you can find a configuration where our buffer is placed before some of those addresses. But before we explore this further, I want to check if any of those addresses are actually being used and called, just to see if that idea would be feasible. And to do that, I simply overwrite them with an invalid address and let the program run and see if it crashes. I use the script to quickly generate the commands to overwrite each possible function address with a unique value. This way, if we get a crash, we know which one caused the crash. Now, I create the minimal test case that doesn't cause any overflow because I don't want to crash from the side effects of the overflow before we get a chance to execute one of these function pointers. I set a breakpoint in the overflow loop, run the binary with the minimal test case, overwrite the potential function pointers. Let's assume our overflow overwrote them, delete the breakpoint, and continue. Boom, we crashed. And look at RIP. So this function pointer with 4F4F4F is called time-wise after our overflow. So if we would manage to get our buffer right before this address, before location-wise, we could overwrite it and redirect code execution. Just for curiosity, what is this function pointer? If we type bt, we can see the backtrace, so all the function calls that led here, and we came from rbfind. If we type up, we go up the call stack into rbfind, and our debug build shows us the line. So apparently we are executing the compare function on a tree structure. Printtree shows that this memory on the heap is an rbtree struct. RB probably means red black tree. Hey, wow, computer science class, red black trees in the wild. Who said theoretical computer science is useless? Anyway, with p star tree, we can also dereference that pointer and print the tree struct. And we can see that this tree struct contains a compare variable. That is a function. So if we find a way to put our buffer right before this buffer, we could overwrite this pointer. Awesome. This function pointer is cool, but it might not be the only useful function pointer. We can do the whole thing again, but do not overwrite the one we know. Then we might crash in a new place. Set breakpoint in the overflow loop, restart the binary, overwrite the function pointers, except the one we know works, delete the breakpoints and continue, boom, we crash again. This time it's 43, 43, 43. Again, with bt, we can look at the call graph and apparently we came from display lecture. Up again to see the causing code line. It's this call sudo conf, so this also contains a function pointer. This is awesome. We have a potential second function pointer we could overwrite. We can repeat this whole process again, but it seems like we don't crash anywhere else. More candidates would of course be better, but I'm also satisfied. We could try to move forward with the two we found. That is already very helpful for us. But the attentive viewer might immediately have noticed that this is not a perfect method to find potential function pointers. Actually, the program might have a lot more function pointers that might be even better for us, but when they are not set by default, we will miss them. Oftentimes, unused function pointers are null by default, and then there is a code that checks that before calling it. So there might be more or even better options to overwrite. But the method of finding function pointers that we used would of course not detect those. But ultimately, it's an engineering problem. For example, we could write more automation to brute force all values on the heap to find those. Might run for a while, but what it could find could be very useful. There are probably also other strategies. For example, we could try to find any function pointer in the C code and add logging information about where it's located on the heap, or maybe even some kind of compiler instrumentation finding all the function pointers. So obviously what we have is not a perfect method, but I thought it's a clever and very easy one. It might be enough. Though I have never tried this before and this might not help us at all, but I give it a shot. So next video we will tackle the second problem. Our function pointers are currently not placed after our buffer, so we cannot overflow them. Which means we need to develop a tool that takes some input we know that influences the heap and let it brute force values. Hopefully, we find a heap layout where those function pointers can be overwritten. I'm excited.